tengo miedo a perderte, perderte después.
Bésame, bésame mucho. Y ya me duele mi objeción. El music divine. Bésame, bésame mucho.
My dear grandchildren, Marina and Greg, and all of you, I think here is not so many people who are living so long as I do. So I wish all of you have at least one such wonderful day. God bless you.
Thank you very much. And now we'd like to invite Marina's mom, Irina. I like your name.
Good. Greg and but I have a great relationship.
True.
Should I say had a great relationship? How do you do? Now I'm your mother-in-law. So I decided that either we are following the experience of generation when we should be enemies or kind of, or I can give you a quiz. And if you choose the right answers, then we'll see. Maybe we'll continue to be friends.
Good luck, Greg.
I know. Help me. Somebody help me.
You have a question, and you have to find the right answer. And you can try to find it yourself. You can ask Marina, or you can ask your mother-in-law and get the right answer. Which one do you choose?
Oh, baby, get it right. Get it right.
First, I ask the mother-in-law, and if she doesn't know, I'll ask grandma's.
Okay. Now, let's say you need an advice. And you can look through some books, internet, or you can ask Marina. Or you can ask your mother-in-law and get the right advice. Which one you choose, Brad?
Oh, maybe this is a trap.
Think hard, Greg.
Internet. Come on, Greg.
Your wife.
Mother-in-law.
Mother-in-law.
Sorry, Marina, I would go to my mother-in-law.
You see that he is smart, right? And the third one, it's harder. Let's say you have to make a decision.
Come on,
very hard one. And you can make it yourself. Or you can ask Marina. Or you can ask your mother-in-law and get the right one. Which one you choose, Brad?
Well,
No, he told you the answer.
This is on video, just reminding you.
Let him talk.
I think from now on, all decisions will be in the hands of my mother-in-law. Thank you.
And now it goes. You see that again. We'll be friends. We knew about
it.
We're friends.
Yes, it
thank
is.
You.
But the toast is that someone said that the love is when we and he or she, about the person next to you, goes before I. And looking at you, I see that you're in love. And I wish you would be in this state as long as possible and have a great, great life. Together.
Yeah. I'm sorry, I do have Marina's mom, and Marina's dad is going to join.
It's division versus toast, okay? Because I'm going to eat Greg first lesson in Russian. Greg. This sacred woman, sacred word, which you're gonna repeat right now.
Oh, yeah.
Yosha!
That means
she's Yosha!
So please, repeat it.
She's my Tosha.
Hi everyone. When Claire and I were thinking about what we wanted to say tonight, we thought, what would Greg do in this situation? What did he do at Claire's wedding? So we decided that instead of preparing anything at all, we would just speak from the heart, because that's who you are, and that's what you do, and we love you, and so we're just going to kind of speak from the heart, so apologies if it's not perfect, but we love you, and so here we go. So I'm Claire. Wanted to just speak about my brother a little bit and say, so my brother, when he decided to go back to, meaning his idea of being a doctor and back to medical school and be a pediatrician, I wasn't at all surprised because my brother's whole life, he's basically been taking care of everyone around him. I think my brother really embodies this idea of gentleness and taking care of people, looking after them. And whether he's looking after young people at Georgetown or looking after us, his sisters, that's what he does. He actually does, even in the sports he plays, whether it's tennis or swimming, he's not even competitive. He just wants to look after people. Which meant I was always better at him than sports. But,
that's true.
So it goes. But no, I love my brother so much, and I think of him always as the guy out exploring the world and hiking mountains in Colorado and living in Dominican Republic, looking after kids, and just always an adventurer and always going further. So Greg, don't ever lose that. Don't lose your sense of gentleness and don't lose your interest in exploring the world, whether it's right here in New York or a very broad world. I love you, brother, and I'm so happy for you guys. I love how happy Marina makes you. So your mother-in-law is always right, but we're always ready to be looked after as well.
Thanks, Bob.
Just to echo that a little bit, I had the great privilege of being with Greg and Marina on the night that they met. And it was Forrest and Marina, and Greg and Marina, and me. But it was one of those things, it was just this surreal night and just this energy, and I looked at my brother and he is the most loving and passionate person. Everyone in this room knows him and knows what an amazing person he is in your heart, and you just give and love, and seeing you look at Marina, and I sat there and I said, I wish I was betting on this because they're gonna fall in love, and you did, and I'm so happy that you did, because Marina, you are amazing, and Claire and I are so happy that you are a sister now and family. And seeing you guys together, honestly, is amazing, and I'm just so happy, Greg. I have no words, and congratulations, and welcome to our family, and thank you for always including me in yours. This has been an amazing night, so congratulations.
Good afternoon, Greg's sisters, Claire and Anna.
Is that table 16? So to start, let's discuss my list of favorite celebrity couples. The first, Brad Pitt and Angelina Jolie, obviously. Or Brangelina. Followed up with a close second. Guys guessed it. It's Tom Cruise and Katie Holmes or Tomcat. So I'm driving recently. My mom gives me a call. She says, Andre, you have to add Marina and Greg to your list. But a name like Megary or Gregina, it just doesn't do the trick. So if anybody has a better name, not now, but later on in the evening, please, please come up and we'll discuss it later on. So, quick story for everybody. It's maybe 1994. I'm 8 years old. Marina's a year and a half older. I'm busy creating two of the largest armies that apartment 307 in Jackson Heights has ever seen. Using toy cars, plastic soldiers, action figures, a couple of pairs of flip-flops, too. 5 feet away, my sister's sitting. She spent the first 10 minutes creating this great army with me. She got bored. So she was reading. At the time, I presumed it was War and Peace, that she was studying strategy to spice up the battle that we were about to have. So single-handedly, I finished setting up Jackson Heights' version of Battle of Waterloo. Excited, I called my sister over for the grand commencement of the battle. She ignores me. I call her over a second time. She gives me one. A third time. I get a, not now. I'm reading, play by yourself. The one I do the fourth time, I slap her as hard as I can over the head. The sirens go off. And she wails, clearly in Russian, to faster alert the Soviet forces in the kitchen. Being my mom and my dad, that there was an issue that needed tending to.
Soviet forces.
Trust my father, clearly affected by the ear-piercing sound exerted by my sister.
Not a nice toast.
Sorry. And while displeased with my sister for having such a horrid shriek for a voice, he's got his sights set on me. I won't get into all the details, but 5 minutes later, I returned bruised and battered, expecting to see pure joy upon Marina's face. Instead, she cried her eyes out and profusely apologizing. Moreover, the Battle of Waterloo was back on, and Marina even agreed to play as the French. The moral of the story is pretty simple. I'm hands down the luckiest kid in the world to have a sister like Marina. Imagine the greatest person you know who's also obliged to take care of you and hang out with you because she turns out to be your big sister. Grades, jobs, friends, family. My sister set an example throughout. She'll never take credit for it. But if not her, I would have probably ended up as a meter maid. In all seriousness, Marina, I can't express how much I appreciate you being you, and how much I love you, and how much your happiness means so much to me. And for that, Greg, I will always be grateful to you. Gee, when I first met you, you were just a Dominican kid that made my sister happy. If you remained as just a Dominican kid that put a smile on my sister's face for the rest of your lives, I'd be thrilled. But you're clearly much more than that to my family and me. You've helped my grandparents with health and other issues countless times. You've built such a strong bond and rapport with my grandfather Remos.
Oh, God.
That he eagerly rubs you down with Soviet potions when you have the flu.
Instead of me! He's never done it to me.
You've broken down the once thick language barrier with both of my grandmothers. You've even broken down the once thick father barrier with my father.
No.
Each one.
It's hard. That's where you and Marina really match. The love, the acceptance, the enthusiasm, you guys share it, and you infect everybody. Look at this entire room. They took an M&G pill and it's going off. They love it. Did you hear the applause before you guys came out? Oh, God. And when you put the two of you together, you end up with something that just feels so right. There's something so natural about it. Regina. It almost feels like your paths uniting is part of some higher truth.
Ooh. Like the Battle of Waterloo?
Maybe. You two are the reason why the Cold War wasn't so cold. Maybe you guys are the reason why global warming isn't that warm.
Sure.
Why Nelson Mandela is a free man. My Nostradamus' prediction of a doomsday next year is false. Like Bruce Willis was able to blow up the asteroid in Armageddon many years back. Because until you two, Marina and Greg, don't live out your lives together, bringing happiness to each other and everyone around you, the world's fate will simply have to wait. It's the one inscription on the Mayan calendar that has been kept a secret for all these years.
Wow, what a toast. That's a serious toast. He's going to be writing the script to Bruce Willis's next movie.
Wait, Marina.
Before beginning, I'd like to offer my sincerest gratitude to Marina and Gregory for allowing me to be a part of this special occasion. I am flattered and honored to be standing with everyone here tonight. Also, I would like to say thank you to Mr. and Mrs. Yaffe for all that you have done to make this the special day that it is. And of course, my gratitude to my Aunt Kate and Uncle Greg for all of your support and all that you have done to make this, by all accounts, the perfect day. So. A few weeks ago, our Gregory asked me to be his best man. It was flattering to say the least, and I still kind of am like in a walking sleep right now. I don't believe this is happening. So I thought to myself, how can the most effortlessly cool guy on the planet ask me to be his best man? And I'm very flattered and honored to be here. So anyway, almost immediately afterwards, I started thinking hard about this toast and the different approaches I could go for and how I was going to address everyone here tonight. One, I could go for jokes and one-liners, but the trouble is I'm just not very funny.
James.
And it's often at the expense of others, and tonight is such a beautiful and joyous occasion. And so scratch that. Two, I thought I could try for eloquence maybe, or maybe some poetry, because Marina is our new resident poet. She's incredible at it, evidently. But the more I researched that, the more difficult that became too. I didn't want to rely on cliches, or even worse, coming off as pretentious. And the only poetry that I knew were bad lyrics from Lou Reed and Mick Jagger, who aren't exactly quotable guys on love and marriage, unless your idea of love is going on a bender in the East Village. So where do I go? I thought I'd get down to the basics, which were my sentiments about my dear cousin Gregory. So here it goes. Gregory to me is the older brother I've never had, the one who is just as good as teaching you important life lessons as he is as taking you on kayak trips. Virtually everything I've learned about culture, life, and love has stemmed from the ground that he has walked on. He has helped friends of mine get into medical school and has always offered his apartment up on the regular. He can quote Hemingway, Marquez, Miller, Thompson, and he can also tell you the menu of Skyline Chili off the top of his head. He is almost too cool. I could spend hours discussing his importance on my life and what he means to me. But what really matters here tonight is his relationship with Marina. Because he is so dear to me and so important, I would like to express my sincere gratitude to Marina for making him the happiest I've ever seen him in all my years of knowing him. So I simply couldn't ask for more. Thank you, and let's toast to their love. Thank you, everyone.
Here we go for our best man, James.
So it was only yesterday that Greg and I were bent over a cadaver during our first week of medical school, terrified of what's to come and covered with the smell of formaldehyde.
It was only yesterday when Marina and I met two 10-year-old girls, and she saved me from the terrorizing koosh ball throwing of her bully baby brother, Andre.
Greg was actually the first person I've ever met who appreciated my Brazilian flamenco soccer shirt. It was the beginning of a beautiful romance.
That's true, Morris, that's true.
Our parents kept forcing us to hang out and made us write satirical skits in Russian together. To this day, I still have no idea what they were about.
And before I knew it, we were living together, sharing meals, sipping wine over dinner, and enjoying endless nights of home and garden television. You would think we were just too tired to change the channel, but Greg just couldn't get enough of the house hunters.
Our Russian theatrical skills did not go unnoticed. We were soon inducted into the Pioneer Society, New York, New Jersey chapter.
I cooked and he ate. What else can I ask for?
Over the years, Marina and I shared many growing pains. Braces, pimples, secret crushes, ugly haircuts, plastic glasses. But all of a sudden, our skin cleared up, we developed boobs, and that's when the boys started lining up.
And during our romantic evenings together, cuddled up on the couch with a blanket and a cup of mint tea, Greg shared his stories, his dreams, his wishes for the future. Although he was a hopeful and a positive fellow, there was always a clear void in his heart.
Marina blossomed into a beautiful, insightful, spontaneous, loyal, and truly one-of-a-kind woman. You could not find another person like her on this planet. And yet she too had a void in her heart. She was missing her to share.
As you can tell, this is where the stories converge. We will spare you all the details, but we'll share some major highlights. Marina and Greg met over corned beef and pierogies. Greg's sister Anne and the two of us were witness. Greg fell in love, Marina came to Philadelphia, there was tres leches cake, salsa dancing, and romantic fire pit the next morning. It's history from then on.
Today, I am extremely honored to be Marina's maid of honor. Thank you for the privilege of letting me join your families under the chuppah today. As you can probably tell, she has been an extraordinary friend to me and an extraordinary person all around. I'm blessed to have her in my life. Among other things, she taught me what it means for friends to become family. I am so happy that she found someone like Greg, her besheret, as we call it in Judaism, who understands her, supports her, loves her, and completes her. Together with Boyd and Greg, we are an unstoppable foursome. You guys know that with this marriage, you are not only committing to each other, but it means you are stuck with us. Marina and Greg, tonight we wish for your lives together to be in complete harmony. We wish that you will always share the childlike, blissful happiness that you do today. There's no way I can explain to this audience the happiness you two bring to each other, but you know what I'm talking about. May you always feel this way together, because beyond that, nothing else matters.
Here's Marina and Greg.
Give it up for the maid of honor, Marina, and great friend, Boris. Please have a few toasts. The brother and cousins of the bride, Rima, Jackie, and Andre.
Hi, guys. First off, Marina and Greg, congratulations. Marina, now that you're married, remember to always exchange good afternoons. Just speaking like a marriage pro here.
Greg, while we're essentially up here toasting for your guys' health and happiness, this toast also serves as a quick life lesson on how things work with Marina.
Greg, where are we going with this, you may be asking yourself. Well, I'm sure you already know, but Marina's kind of smart. She's also Marina. This combination is deadly. In other words, she's usually right. So, to serve as an example to you, the following are our stumbles into a Marina that's usually right.
I'm nervous. I'm so nervous.
Remember that summer 15 years ago upstate when you said I didn't get encephalitis from the community lake?
You were right.
summer 10 years ago upstate when you said you can eventually convince Grandma to give us a later curfew?
You were right. Marina, remember the past 20 years of our lives when you said you'd probably get better grades than I would?
You were right.
Remember 20 years ago when you got that ear infection and said it would hurt like a beep after I'd eventually get it?
You were right.
Remember when you said one day my Russian would be just as good as yours?
Remember 18 years ago when you told me to be careful on those porch stairs upstairs or else I could trip, fall, and get appendicitis?
You were right.
So, Greg, you see, arguing with Marina will usually end up with her being right 5 out of 6 times.
Though, in the past, I do remember Greg having his fair share of right.
Good point, Jesse.
Greg, remember when you said that in your professional medical opinion, it was safe to eat that piece of chicken off our grandmother's floor?
You were right.
Remember when you said one day your Russian will be as good as mine?
You were right! Greg, remember when you once told me that your breakfast burritos can cure anger disorders and athlete's foot?
You were right.
3 for 3 versus 5 for 6. Quite the even matchup in retrospect.
Good point.
Really? May you guys not keep score. We can do it for you if necessary.
We appreciate it.
And may you and Greg continue to share
happiness,
Mexican food,
intimacy,
Queen's South bike racing,
unity,
sweet haircuts,
longevity,
clean dishes,
and of course, joy, success, and lots of babies.
Woo!
We'll be right here, listening to your advice and occasionally giving some of our own.
But mostly sharing in the new memories that you guys make. We love you.
We love you. Woo!
Give it up for them. I see a common theme with Marina and her mom, Irina. It's always, you're right. Mom's always right. You gotta listen to mom, then you gotta always listen to Marina, Greg. So now we'd like to invite Greg's brother-in-law to make a toast, Adil.
Congratulations, Greg and Marina, on this wonderful occasion. I have the good fortune of being Greg's brother-in-law. I'm married to his sister, Claire. And shortly after Claire and I started dating, Greg opened his world and his heart to me and welcomed me into his family. And I quickly understood what family means to Greg. And by the time that Claire and I got married, the term brother-in-law didn't make much sense because we already felt like brothers. And you can really see what family means to Greg when you see how he treats his sisters and how he treats his parents and his cousins and his grandparents and his whole family. And Marina, I know from hanging out with you and getting to know your family that the Yaffies share that spirit. And so I don't want to just congratulate the two of you, but I want to congratulate all the Kennys and the Yaffies because we get to share your love of family and just be inspired by you each and every day. So thank you so much for that. Thank you for everything that you are for all of us. And much love to you both.
And now we're gonna invite a good friend, Thad, to make a toast.
Adios. Adios. Hey everyone. I'm Thad, and I have the privilege of being Greg's roommate at Georgetown for 4 years.
4 years.
And,
what a mess.
Woo!
4 years.
I first heard about Greg the summer before we started our freshman year, and I was out of the country for the summer, and my mom had gotten a letter in the mail saying that Greg was going to be my roommate. And she called me and said, I got a chance to talk to your roommate. He was a great guy, seemed really sweet. He does have a hearing impairment, so it was hard to have a conversation with him. And I was like, oh, well, that's interesting. And so I got to Georgetown. We became fast friends. We hung out a lot. And after the first couple weeks, I said, Greg, what was the deal with the conversation? I thought you had a hearing impairment. And he said, well, I couldn't understand your mom's Alabama accent. And so I just told her I was hearing impaired. But he learned to understand your accent. And we ended up living together all 4 years. We're great friends, had so many amazing memories, and have stayed good friends. And one of the things that I always respected and loved about Greg was his humility and humbleness. And he knows so much and has been all over the world and is a linguist and is just such an impressive guy, but he's never had a pretension in the world. He's just totally solid and is someone you can always depend on. And he called me the Sunday after he had met Marina and was just gushing about this girl he had met, and she was amazing, and she knew all these languages, and he was just completely in awe, and I could just tell she was someone special, and I think you found your match, and you guys make an amazing couple, and I'm so excited for you, and Annie and I wish you all the best in the world, and we look forward to many future memories with you guys. Congratulations. Yeah.
Beautiful dad. And now we'd like to invite a friend, David.
Hello, everybody. I also know Greg from Georgetown.
David.
Greg was also my roommate for 4 years too. Actually,
did you know that he was hearing impaired?
No, I didn't know that. I didn't know he was Dominican either.
Venezolano.
I do know, well, one thing, I don't want to talk too much about being roommates because, you know, Greg met Marina after he went to college. And I wanted to talk a little bit about the summer after Greg and I graduated from college. We both moved to New York. We actually lived here for a year in New York City. I was doing a master's, and Greg was teaching English at a small school in Harlem, which, as you've seen tonight, Greg is a guy with a big heart, and he was, you know, from the minute I met him. So, but he was teaching in Harlem, and I remember, though, that year he would complain a lot about New York City. I mean, not to disparage anybody here, I mean, New York's a wonderful city. Actually, I was actually born here. But Greg would always say, oh, there's no nature here, you know, like, and I remember he packed up his bags the day that he moved out of New York, and he said something like, you know, if I never come back to the city again, you know, I'll be happy for the rest of my life. You know, it's something to that respect. He didn't want to live here ever again. So, you know, when Greg called me and let me know that he had met this girl, Marina, and he's always just said wonderful things about Marina and how much, you know, how much he liked her and then loved her, and then he said he was moving to New York. And then he said, you know, and I remember, like, the several conversations that I've had with him, you know, that I had with him over the years, he said, well, yeah, we're going to live in New York. And I always remember that. I was like, wow, he must really, really love this girl. He must really, really be special, because I remember he said he never wanted to live in New York again. And then when I met, after meeting Marina, I saw how she made Greg feel. And seeing your family and that wonderful ceremony that you had for him, and it being in Russian and very, very respectful of all of the traditions of her family, I knew that, you know, Greg had found his place. because see, Greg and I were both explorers. We actually traveled all over Brazil together about 5 years ago, and I'm very happy that Greg has found a family to explore and grow with, you know. So cheers to you, cheers to your new wife, and Yada and I are so happy for both of you. We love you, and we hope to see you for many years. We hope our kids will play together for many years to come.
And,
we have one more toast. One more. Let's invite Aunt Jan and Bill.
This is an interactive toast. I need the groom's mother, my sister Kate, to come down here. Kate, your son and cousin. I need Irina to come in here.
I'm nervous.
Don't be nervous. We need you. We need your mama. You know that you're nervous?
I don't know.
Okay, where's Kate? Okay. And we need Craig, and we need Irina, and we need Marina. Okay.
Okay, now, although this is a Russian wedding, I thought I'd bring some Italian custom to it. Because, you know, Italians are a very good party, so. Well, it's Russian. No, I don't know him at all, but that's irrelevant. So, what I need first is, Irina, I'd like you to place your hand here. Kate, you're the mother of the bride. You're the mother of the groom. Place your hand on top of hers. Marina, you are now Mrs. Greg Kenny. You place her hand here. Easy, easy. Hold on now. Everybody get your hand on your glasses. Greg, you are Dr. Greg Kenny. Place your healing hand here.
Dr. Greg Kenny.
Wouldn't that sound good, Dr. Greg Kenny? I would never be a doctor. Dr. Greg. Oh, yeah. Okay. Yeah, thank you. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like you to all raise your glasses because you are now witness to the last time in Gregor's life that he will have his hand, upper hand, over these three women. Salute.
The father of the bride has given her away today, and although in his mind she'll always be his little girl, she's now a wife, and so this song is for them.
Взрослый совсем.
give it up for Maria and her dad. Okay, and now we'd like to invite Greg to the dance floor with his beautiful mother, Kate, for their dance. We can all snap. Come on, we can make it loud. Snap.
And the land is dark, and the moon is the only light we'll see. No, I won't be afraid. Oh, I won't be afraid. Just as long as you stand.
Thank you.
Yes, and Kate, I guess this is unexpected. I don't know. I mean, I was told that was beautiful. All right.
Yeah. York, Vegas, or Africa. Dance the night away, maybe let him stay out on the floor.
Yeah.
still my soul. I keep it shining everywhere I go. You're my heart, you're my soul. I'll be holding you forever, staying with me together.
поезд ушел. Мэр летит просто, чтоб подождем другого. И чтоб на перроне скучать не пришлось, мы накроем стол и выпьем за любовь, и будет хорошо.
Also, I love giving toasts in case some of you don't know. My parents, though, they deserve awards and praise until the end of days. That rhymed by accident. They are incredible people on their own, but together they make the strongest team that I've ever seen, even if some of you may not believe it. I've seen them go through many things and come out on top. I have seen them succeed in ways that I could never imagine possible. And for that, they are forever something to strive towards. On top of that, without them, there would be no wedding. Greg and I would still be looking for a venue. So they definitely gave us a strong push here. They've given us everything, and I am willingly quite indebted to them for it. I'm also very grateful to Greg's family, thankful to his parents, because they not only made Greg into the amazing person that he is, but they also give us a constant stream of love and support, and I can't see them at all from where I stand, but I know that they're out there, at least I hope. Cincinnati has become a second home for me. And I know that with a second set of parents comes great responsibility. But it is a responsibility that I'm willing to take on. It's especially since it's looking not only to be a source of love and support, but also a source of dogs and race cars. Through this marriage, I also get two sisters, and don't get me wrong, Andre has always been all the sister that I've ever needed. But having two sisters under the size of 6'2 is incredible. And we are all very lucky to be surrounded by many generations, by uncles and aunts. Greg's family is a veritable force to be dealt with. And I've met definitely more than half, I think, at this point. Which puts me in a pretty good position seeing as how we're married now. But I only have two. I only have an uncle and an aunt, and I have two cousins, and they're also very strong on their own. And if you want a good story, you talk to Alex. If you want some dancing, there's Jackie. And Joe. I'm sorry, Joe. And, you know, I would say that everybody here probably understands how lucky we are to have so many grandparents with us. And their lives have been and are incredible. We're lucky to have the grandparents who are with us here. We're lucky to have the memory of those who couldn't be here. And, you know, we're planning to have our grandparents raise our children. Ed'll let me know why later, but, you know, they've raised more than one generation, they've done it successfully, so we know that they can do it better than us, so we're just gonna pass that on. The beauty in this gathering on top of everything is that the people here show that the concept of family goes well beyond blood. My parents, Sasha and Ira, obviously, took the idea of it takes a village to raise a child and put it into practice. I have at least 15 sets of parents here. Sometimes I call them aunts and uncles, just to give my real parents some respect. These are people who have given me advice, they yelled at me, they stopped bleeding wounds, and eventually they danced with me and poured me many a shot. Many parents means many siblings. It only took us about 10 years to realize that we like each other, and didn't just hang out because our parents forced us to. So I grew up with a sense of family, and nothing gives me greater pleasure than to see it enacted in full, with so many loved ones in this one room. So thank you for coming out. Thank you for celebrating with us. Thank you for loving us. Family makes us all stronger, and our family has just doubled in size. The possibilities are endless.
I would like a big round of applause for my wife. Wife? She's amazing. She's amazing. And for the pure love that I feel in the room, the good energy is amazing tonight. It's amazing. Before we came here, we took pictures under the Verrazano Bridge at a park. It was like 90 degrees. But it was really appropriate because I would spend every Friday afternoon on the Verrazano Bridge coming to visit Marina. And, you know, in a way it's a symbol of our love and the bridge that connected Philadelphia to New York City. And I'm glad I never have to go back to Philadelphia again. But I think the Verrazano Bridge is beautiful. It's my favorite bridge in New York, and it was a beautiful place. We did meet at a Polish restaurant, but Marina will not admit it, because the borscht wasn't very good. And like my sister said, it was love at first sight, and we sat across the table, and I remember sleeping at Boris's house that night in New Brunswick, and I could not sleep the entire night. I literally couldn't sleep. I was like, what is wrong with me? What is this feeling? And I really say it was love at first sight. I mean, it exists. I'm telling you, it exists. It's true. It exists. It's fabulous. But but I think it took Marina a little longer. Not very long. She came to my Valentine's Day / birthday party, and she put paper flowers on all my med school friends' ears and clothes, and like she was the wildest one there, and it was pretty much love. And we sat in the front yard and drank daiquiris and made a campfire in the front yard of the apartments. And I was like, wow, this girl's amazing. And then I told her my favorite foods were Mexican and Indian. And she was like, oh my God, me too. And I think that's what really clinched it. And that's kind of why Jackson Heights works for us too. And that's a funny story too, because, you know, paths cross, and my dad actually grew up in Jackson Heights until he was like 6 years old, and his window on 34th Avenue, and he could see the planes going to LaGuardia, and his first word was airplane. Like, he would point to the planes, and that was literally his first word. And so, you know, it's interesting that a woman I meet through all these circuitous pathways lives a block and a half from where my dad grew up. So, you know, fate probably exists too, and it's wonderful. There's a certificate of maturity on Marina's bathroom wall, our bathroom wall, and it's like silly and it entitles her to use drugs and alcohol and adult material. But, you know, she's not fully mature, and part of the reason I love Marina is that she's a wild, well, she has a passion for life, let's put it that way. As Marina Zeltzer once said, that Marina has a great chaotic effect on life. And I have a great calming effect. And maybe that's why we get along so well. But it's true that it's all about chemistry. That's really like what I've learned, is that it's all about chemistry. And we have an amazing chemistry. And you have to communicate, you know, and use words together. And, you know, we just always are on the same damn page. And it's amazing. And it's fitting for a poet. And, you know, we just sort of agree. And I think that part of our success, key to happiness, is that at any given, you know, life is just, I think, a series of decisions. And at any decision, we generally want the same choice. And so there's really very, very few disagreements. And, you know, for that, it's just easy. It just makes life with you easy. So a very important moment in our relationship came, I don't know, I'm not very good at dates, maybe 2 or 3 months ago. And, you know, I said to Marina, it was a moment where we called each other best friends. And it was an interesting realization to be, you know, in love, and love is so strong between us, and then to realize that we're also best friends. And that, like, really, really touched both of us, and it was an amazing moment, and I think, you know, that's also part of why we're so happy. I think you have to be in love and be best friends. So, Marina, I love you. This is amazing. Oh, I have some thank yous. First of all, to Sasha and Irina for throwing this wedding. It's fabulous. You guys are amazing. I'd like everybody to clap for Marina's time. Sasha's generosity is fantastic. I've been to maybe
100 Russian restaurant parties, and never have I ever been able to find a way to sneak in the bill. Like, Sasha pays for me at every single Russian restaurant party, and, you know, I love him like a dad, and he's been fabulous, and...
He is your dad!
He is my dad.
Uncle!
And Irina, you're just pure... Where's Irina? Oh, yeah. Yeah, you're just consistent, pure love, and it's amazing, and you're an amazing woman, and I thank you, too. And you made her dress. It's fabulous. You're amazing. To my parents, my dad, for his, he's always supporting me. We're best friends. I went through a great party last night, and I'm always thankful to my dad. My mother, for always just full of love for me. I think we share a soul. How much deeper can you get? And she would get a lot of help to this wedding, and she has beautiful handwriting. Nina, Ramos, Anya, you guys have been pure love. You know, I think we've overcome language barrier and become friends, and I look forward to many more years with you. You have been purely wonderful to me. I thank you for incorporating me in your family. Andre, your toast was awesome. Where's Andre?
It's right there.
Oh, yeah. You're a brother. You're an absolute brother. You're awesome.
He's looking at rebellion.
He's a rebellion. He's amazing. My own sisters are incredible. I love them dearly. They're beautiful, beautiful sisters. I'm so glad to become closer in the last few years. Boris and Marina, James, I can't say enough. The rest of my family who traveled a long way, Palm Beach County, Washington, D.C., Cincinnati, the whole Ohio contingent who came. I love you guys. Thank you so much. Stephanie, the first friend I ever met of Marina's. It was all shots and loving pants, and I love you. And the whole Queens crew who was... You guys are amazing. You've integrated me into I feel safe in Queens. Thank you. So that's all for my toast. I love you all. I feel lots of love in the room. It's amazing. I hope we can dance some more. Thank you.
It's time for the garden bouquet ceremony. What I'm gonna need is definitely single ladies, and of course the single men, same thing. We will come hunt you down. Okay, so come right over here, Greg. You're gonna take a long walk away from your bride, and I need our best man James and our maid of honor, Marina, down. But what you're gonna have to do here is, see, you're far away, you're about 10 steps away from Marina. And what you're gonna have to do is you're gonna have to tell her 10 promises, give her 10 promises. She's not your wife, but you have to make 10 promises to her in front of all these people, and of course the cameras. And I promise you, if you don't fulfill one of your promises, Marina will sit you down, turn on the DVD, and rewind. Okay, so make sure every promise is something you really wanna do, all right? And for every promise, you can take a step forward. So let's go.
Okay. Life is sort of about the simple things, so we'll start there. I promise I will always make good coffee. I promise I will always make more food than you can eat, especially breakfast foods. I promise I will rub your back every single night that you ask me to. When it's leg night at the castle, I promise you always have veto power. There's always the veto power in the end for any given decision.
Ooh.
That's huge.
That's a big one.
That's the number one answer.
That's to be used respectfully. Judiciously. I will promise that I will always walk through Jackson Heights with you in the evening when it's windy, just to calm you down if you would like me to. I promise we could turn the air conditioning down to like 71 whenever you want me to. I promise that we'll get full-size screens on our windows one day. I promise there will always be a good selection of hot sauce because that's your number one key to happiness. promise.
Tomorrow. Love you. But she's gonna tell you, and then you can say it into the mic. No, no.
Hello? Hello? She's not in right now.
Oh. Okay, ask your mother-in-law. All right.
Yeah, she's got the answers.
Yeah, talk to the mother. She has all answers. I know.
I promise that I'd never retire for dinner at your grandparents' house.
And the final promise.
Make it good. Make it real good.
That sounds like promise.
Say that one more time.
I promise that no matter what happens on any given day in our life, we will just be in bed to hold on to each other at the end of the night. And that's all that really matters, as long as we can just lay there and, like, grip onto each other. And I'll always be there for you to do that.
Thank you, drummer.
Yeah.
Greg, you got the number one answer. You won. You won $1 million. Okay. All right, Greg, I'm going to ask you guys to sit down. Thank you so much for your help. You're going to move back a little bit just so you can get your groove on, because we're going to turn on some sexy music. You have to make this sexy. Woo! You know,
I can make it sexy.
It's the start of your wedding night, so, you know, make it good. You got to take off the garter. Come on, let's cheer him on. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
This is Marina's fantasy.
Street boy.
Maybe we could take the tie off. Take this garter and put it over your head. Put it on your head like a headband. Turn around to everybody. Everybody can see. Turn around to Marina. Take a good look, because this is what your future kids will look like. I think it's cute. I think it's pretty cute. Hold on to the garter, because we're gonna need it in a second. And now, I'm gonna ask Marina to come over here. All the single ladies, come on down to the dance floor. How are your pitching skills?
Terrible.
Awesome. This is going to be so much fun. Okay, ladies, everybody come a little closer together. And I'm going to ask you to put both hands up in the air to get ready to catch. And on the count of three, Marina's going to throw. One, two, and three. Oh my God, thank you.
Whoa, we have a winner. Ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah.
I'm a single lady.
What's your name? Stephanie.
As a youngin, was too much to cope with. Why you think motherfuckers in this name the good ghost shit? Should have been called Tom Robbery, Exhaustion, or maybe Grand Larceny. I did it all.
All right, Greg, come on down. Right over here with me. And on the count of three. On the count of three. Greg's gonna throw it. One, two, and three. I guess you really wanted that. You know what? You can stay right here.
That's a done deal.
Very nice job. Thank you guys. Thank you guys so much for coming out. What is your name? Christian. Christian. You know, for Christian. Does Stephanie have a boyfriend here? Does Christian have a girlfriend here? No. Awesome. Great. I love when that happens. Okay. Stephanie, take a seat over here. We're going to come over here. And remember what Greg said? What Greg had to do, he had to make 10 promises. Now, you can't make 10 promises to somebody you don't know. But you can say 10 nice things about her. You can find 10 nice things about Stephanie just by looking at her. Let's go.
Starting now?
Yes.
One. You're holding a bouquet of flowers. You look like a flower holding those. I think that's wonderful.
Okay, nice. He's a poet, too.
Number two, I don't know a lot about fashion, but I like your shoes. It sort of gives a Roman vibe. You look like a nice Roman. Romans are important in history. You're going to be important in my life. I think that fits. Another one. Okay, well, I'll push it out.
No pressure.
Another one. I was blessed with a very pasty skin color. I see you have a much more lucrative one. I think that's a wonderful quality.
And stand-up comedy. I love this. It's good.
Again, I don't know a lot about hair styles. That one looks like it took a lot of time. I think everyone appreciates it. It looks lovely on that. And again, has some Roman braid. Another Roman vibe going.
You're picking up.
We're working on it. And you'll notice I'm moving closer with every one.
That is how it works.
Also, I saw you in the wedding party. We were in that blue hallway, the blue greenhouse, for quite some time. Looked like you had a lot of energy to you. I think that that's contagious, and that's a wonderful thing. I like that also.
I think this is the beginning of a wonderful romance.
It's happening right now. It's being recorded. Also, ooh, this one literally just happened. Check out your nail polish. It matches on the hands and the feet. It's purple. That's a very seductive, sort of mysterious color. Boom. Love it. Your necklace reminds me of when in The Little Mermaid she goes into the ship and finds a bunch of things. It's like you made a necklace out of it, but you only pick the good stuff, and I think that's really cool.
Little Mermaid. He's a sensitive man.
How many is that?
Eight?
Yes, eight. It's been eight.
That works.
You're doing good.
He's shaking. He's
your voice, it sounds like a little Marissa Tomei vibe. I feel like you're kind of a spunky girl. It's like very seductive, but also, you know, friendly. And I think that's a great quality you have, and it's going to work really well for our future together. So that's great.
Wow.
And the coup de grace.
Finally, you know, sometimes it can be hard to find a song to sing to a girl, or it can be your song, but my brown-eyed girl, you got brown eyes. As I can see now that I'm this close, so it's nice that we have that.
Can you sing on over there?
That would require some more bottles of liquor on every table.
We can do that. There you go. He's accommodating. Toss it back and sing his song. No pressure. Just a chorus. You used to sing? La 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 la.
That was 10. All right. Thank you so much, Christian. But the fun is not over. We're not going to let you go so easily. See, Greg is married and He's, you know.
He gets all the privileges.
You don't. And since you're such a good sport, we're gonna have some fun with you. So we're gonna blindfold him. I think that's a good idea. That's number one. And then, if anybody, what have you been drinking all night?
A lot of them.
I wish it had been just one thing.
Yeah. Oh, so, okay, what would you like? We have vodka, cognac on the tables.
We'll stick with the whiskey.
Whiskey? Do we have some whiskey? If someone can pour him a shot of whiskey and bring it down to the dance floor. No, you don't get anything. More fun. He'll be better.
And this is the treat that we don't know.
Look at Marina. Marina, the bride, right? The one who's bringing down the whiskey. This is nice. Okay, come on down over here. Take the shot. We're going to say shot, 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 shot.
Hey, she's like, I could use a shot. I could use a double right about now. I don't know what's about to happen to me, but I could use a double right now.
Okay, what I need you to do, Christian, right now, is you're gonna stay right here, right in your place, and I need you to turn around 7 times. We're all gonna count, right, till 7. So 1, 2, 3. 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, very nice job. Thank you, Christian. Thank you so much. Okay, right here. You're standing right here with me. Everybody give Christian a big round of applause. He's holding on to me for dear life. We're gonna turn around this way. Turn around with me. Right here. Okay. We're gonna move Stephanie a little closer. Come a little closer to me. Because there was a little glass that spilled. We don't want Christian to get any glass. Sit right over here, Stephanie. Sit down. Thank you so much. Christian, okay, come on back. We're gonna turn on some sexy music. Get down on both knees. You're right in front of her. I just need you to touch the floor and see where her beautiful leg is. Just keep going forward. Keep going forward. Right here. This way, this way. That's right, that's where it is.
Baby, take off your coat. We need a scroll. Yeah. Get it, tune it down. Take your time, take your time. Real slow, sexy and slow. Take off your shoes.
Woo!
Baby, take off your dress.
All right, that's high enough, that's high enough. All right, now take off your blindfolds. Take it off.
Oh!
He shaved his legs just for you.
But you don't know on her, right?
But we're gonna do it for real this time. So Stephanie, come sit down right over here. That was practice. I think he's doing a good job. That was practice. Christian, we're gonna do it for real this time. We need the garter back. We need the garter back.
We need the garter. Yeah.
Oh, we need it back. We do. Christian. You did a great job with the 10 promises. Did you know? Did you know it was not set?
Like she has sort of a European vibe going. I was like, that would be number 11. So.
All right, we're gonna turn some sexy music back on. Think of this as your first date. I don't know. Enjoy.
Oh yeah. Once again, take your time, man. Yeah.
May 2012.
Used to be
so easy to give my heart away.
Everybody can feast their eyes on this beautiful cake. Marina baked it all night last night, actually.
Tired.
In their oven in Jackson Heights, and then brought it all the way here and still managed to put on a dress, get her makeup done, do her hair, and look as beautiful as she does today. So, Marina, round of applause to you. And they're gonna cut the cake. You guys do it however you want to do it. Cut the nicest piece. And of course, in paradise, we like to say if you really, 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 really love each other, you can use your hands to feed each other.
Really?
So I think that applies to you. No, no, no.
Hey.
All right, let's get the music going.
Yeah, I like that. Woo!
He really, really, really loves it.
Любви, еще раз счастья и еще раз любви. И чтобы вся так жизнь их происходила.
Congratulations, Gregory. We're so happy for you. We all love you. Love your cousins, Emily and Kevin and Ryan and his fiance Alyssa. We love you. Congratulations.
Thank you, Greg, for all the wedding ideas. Thank you so much again for having us. I really appreciate it, especially my fiance Alyssa.
Marina, this is your Jackson Heights crew right here.
718.
I know. Just want to say you are like a little sister to me. I've known you for so many years now, and I'm just so happy to be here. And I just want to wish the best of luck to you and Greg. Congratulations, and you know, best of luck to both of you.
I want to repeat everything he said.
We've known each other a very long time.
He's in diapers.
Yes, we've known Gregory since he was a little boy. Baby. He was my son's best friend.
Yeah. They went to school together.
And we are so happy to be here and enjoying this wonderful evening. And we love Marina. And I think this is so much fun.
And he's just as adorable today as he was in diapers.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Дорогие Мариночка и Грегори, поздравляю вас с бракосочетанием. Желаю вам здоровья, удачи, долгих лет совместной жизни. Чтобы у вас все было благополучно. Вы только радовали друг друга. И много здоровья и счастья. Всего нам наилучшего.
Мариночка и Грегори, поздравляем вас с днем бракосочетания. Желаю вам долгой, счастливой семейной жизни. Любите друг друга. Пусть каждый год ваша любовь становится крепче и крепче. Целуем, поздравляем.
Дорогие Мариночка и Грегори, поздравляем вас с таким замечательным днем. Дай Бог, чтобы он длился у вас счастливый такой долго, до 120, чтобы вы были счастливы, чтобы жизнь вас радовала, чтобы вас окружали хорошие дети. Счастья вам и здоровья на долгие годы.
Дочка, я желаю тебе всего самого хорошего. Guys, I wish you all the best. You know, when I'm looking at you guys, I'm just thinking about my kids, like in 20 years and 15 years, being the same as you. Happy and beautiful. Guys, wish you all the best on the whole world. Let this marriage bring everything you want. Okay? I kiss you and I love you.
Мариночка и Грегор, мы от всей семьи нашей Курант поздравляем вас с днем свадьбы. Счастья вам, долгих лет совместной жизни в окружении своих родных и близких и друзей. Всего вам наилучшего.
Congratulations, Gregory and Marina. This is your uncle Jeff Gregory, and we wish you nothing but the best, and have a wonderful life together.
Gregory and Marina, just a happy and healthy marriage. It's a wonderful wedding, and we really enjoyed ourselves here tonight.
We hope them a good future.
To Marina and Greg, on behalf of the medical school and extension family, we love you all, and congratulations on this wonderful day.
Greg and Marina, I just want to say I love you all so much.
Dr. Kenny, thank you for showing your presence at 621 Reed Street. You blessed that house, and I am honored to know you.
Greg, it's just been so great to be here and to support you. We're so excited for you guys and know you're going to have a wonderful life together.
And we know that you're such a blessing to your community and to your family, and we can't wait to get to know Marina better.
Greg and Marina, I love you. Best wishes from Carol and I. Thank you so much for inviting us. I had a great time. And Mazel Tov, thank you.